And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity. I'm the RPG chick, continuing into Galvino's workshop, which is kind of looking like a cavern right now. Cave coral? Little burn lady. Trap detected.
Now this I haven't seen. What?
What, a trap? You've seen traps before.
That's settled.
And that's settled.
Got it.
I hear more of those sounds like someone's trying to disarm a trap over and over. Iron construct. Maybe these things just make this sound? Now everyone except for Kana, because he has a cursed weapon, so he can't switch to his ranged weapon. So everyone except him. I have hair here. Yeah. These things run fast, so I keep hitting the mic like that.
Don't even slowing it down!
I slow it down for like half a second.
Ow.
Oh, there's more. They're not sold in any store. Boom. You can also attack.
I'm ready.
Kana, please attack. Oh god. And you can't switch weapons. My god, we keep getting destroyed by these explosions. Oof, let's just rest right here. I'm glad I didn't rest right after that last band. Okay.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah, hello.
No problem.
We're all eager to greet you. Except they want to kill us after that. Anyone there? Is that some kind of trap? Bring our master mechanics artist closer. Yeah, there's one there.
And the fire shows me something new.
Failing. All right. Oh, we're going that way. Okay, I guess we're going that way. Let's see if we don't fall into a trap. Looks like so far so good. Boom. Boom. Knock down, boom. Bounding missile. Let's just do a whatever you call that. Soul ignition.
I'm ready.
You have to go that way, and we can stop sneaking now.
Following your
that we didn't run into the trap.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea.
What was that?
Which is not very quiet.
Yeah, shut up. Crumpled experimental notes. This crumpled piece of parchment was found jammed inside the faceplate of a construct. My efforts to instill even a child's intelligence in these creations have all failed. Most cannot hold a quill, much less set thoughts to paper. I believe for some time that Subject 63 might have had a breakthrough during its lessons, but I discovered that it has simply been repeating my words without comprehension. These were not enlightened characters while they wore their original skins. Perhaps their essence lacks a fundamental capacity for learning? I have put them to the test in more martial arts, but here too they falter without the benefit of true sentience. The devil, of course, delights in mocking them. It is like boasting of besting children in combat. If I only had my old machines. Interesting.
Yeah.
Anything down here? Guess not. This is a huge dungeon. Call it a workshop. A little underwhelming to call this a workshop. It's down this way then. An iron construct is here. Alright, let's get that then, I guess.
That's not very helpful.
Chain lightning. These others are going to catch up. Hopefully in time. When they explode, it's so bad. Oh my god. Damn it. Gon's pledge. Drink a potion. Drink a potion. Get ready for the big boom. Should probably attack it with ranged weapons, but I don't want to bother with that. We don't all die now. Cool, okay. Damn, gonna have to leave and come back for camping supplies. Ooh, exceptional rapier. I don't see those very often, rapiers. I don't know what kind of accent I just got all of a sudden.
Sure.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Alright, we were trying to explore down here. It's like a mine. That's another one of those levers. Let's check out here first.
Nice and quiet.
Trapped? Trap box?
What?
Go by the trap box.
Hey.
Get out of his way so we can go by the trap box. No? Okay. A cell key. Oh, good. I guess we wouldn't have been able to get that guy out anyway. A plain iron key found discarded in Galvino's workshop. Oh, I didn't actually get it. There we go. An exceptional warhammer. Okay. We didn't even bother trying to get him. Alright, let's go see what the rest of this crap is. Down here with this.
Keeping an eye out.
Can't be too much from left. That was the testing ground, yep. Still can't get past here. Maybe Galvino will let us in there? I'm assuming he's the one trapped. You know, what about this? Oh, that's the bookcase! Okay, good. We've been in there, so let's just go through here with the key. Oop. Hello? Galvino. Okay, who's in the cell? An elderly man hunches over a cluttered desk in the back of the workshop. His flesh is pulled tightly around thin, fragile-looking bones, except around his neck, where it hangs in loose waddles. Sounds very attractive. He turns as you enter, a scowl already chiseled into his lined face.
Back again? I told you.
He hesitates, squinting at you from behind smudged and dusty spectacles.
Of course, a fresh fool to replace the last fools. What brings you stomping through my workshop, eh?
He draws his words out, looking you up and down. A sneer creeps across his face. I sell false teeth? What were those things?
My work. And from the racket outside, I must assume you made a mess of them.
He scowls at you. You're not very fond of them anyway.
Come on, Galvino, they weren't your best work.
The voice echoes from within the golem. Awesome, that's that other NPC. Devil of Caroc. Well, that's what he mentioned, the devil, in one of these, one of his papers that he's written down. I didn't know he literally meant her, I believe.
And you are? I should melt you for parts, Amora.
Let's just clear our throat. Why not?
But you come seeking the White Forge, like they all do. Boys with smooth cheeks and wild dreams. Girls with bright ribbons tied next to their scabbards.
His voice rises and falls with the sing-song of mockery.
Old men and women, too, seeking a final blaze of glory before they're snuffed out for another turn at the wheel. Sound familiar?
His smile is rigid as he looks at you, and the corner of his eye twitches. I'd rather strive for greatness than wither in the shadows.
Pazzo! Most bold for one who came seeking my help.
His wrinkled face scrunches in fury.
I have this conversation with every pig-headed swashbuckler those Postanagos and stalwarts send here.
Postanagos?
Go see Galvino, they say. Surely he'll help you.
Must have slipped their minds. What a busy and important fellow you are.
In the silence that follows, the temperature in the room seems to drop. Galvino glares at her.
They should have let them stone you. Would have silenced your endless rattling forever.
The hanging folds of skin beneath his neck tremble.
Then you'd have naught but those frostbitten inbreds for company.
Haha. Adair says, I guess this is what it'd be like if Aeloth and Islemir were two separate people. I love Adair, he's awesome. Aeloth says, come now, I sound nothing like either of them. Mr. Galvino. I said that right. I would really appreciate your help, please.
Of course you would. What would anyone here do without me? I
tell you.
He breaks off, looking suddenly startled. Galvino pauses long enough to take a deep breath. He folds his hands and bows his head.
Siéntate. It has been a long time since anyone addressed me so.
He clears his throat before continuing. Oh, he liked that. You were respectful.
The villagers and their adventurers hammer and pry at the battery as if they were laying siege to some moldering lord's keep.
He swats the air in front of his face.
But those stones were laid by some of the finest builders ever to have lived. Disciples of Abaddon in the truest sense. They will not fall by the whims of any kith. And the door itself, it is infused with living essence.
He holds his hands before him, and his eyes are wide with wonder. Well, the dwarves themselves must have had a way of getting in.
Perfetto! This is the crux of the matter.
He claps his hands together.
The Pargrunen of Durgan's battery perished within their own keep, victims of a violent disagreement among their own commandants.
His mouth twists into a wicked grin.
Surely in the village you have heard stories, no? Disappearing caravans, tracks in the snow, screams from the high towers.
He pauses, watching your expression with the raconteur's glee. Sorry, guys. Some of these words I don't know. Kenna says, well, go on. I like this story so far.
The work of spirits still trapped in the battery, and a testament to those impenetrable walls.
He raps on the mortared stone of his own home.
But the door of the keep, the one the Pargrunen filled with essence, oh, it was made to listen, to recognize its masters.
So I need the door to recognize me?
Traditional Optapo cultures revolved around language. Words revealed who they were and where they were from.
An interesting tradition, Kenna says. I could start introducing everyone in verse.
That is why you need a Kandek.
He holds up a twitching finger. Yes, I believe those are anthems of sorts.
Ah, that's the simple explanation.
He nods.
A Kandek is a statement of purpose, a declaration of identity. Each is unique to its stronghold.
Ha! Durant says. Seal your door with a key of words and any liar can talk his way through. There's nothing built of words that won't break when the slightest stress is applied.
Thus, to enter a fortress like Durgan's battery, you would stand at the gate and recite its Kandek.
He spreads his arms, his face aglow. Yeah, let's humor the guy. What an incredible tradition.
Verus! A shame the Postanagos here cannot appreciate such elegance. To learn the Kandek, you must speak with one of the dwarves of Durgan's battery. A shame they are all dead, no?
He rubs his hands together, pacing. Well, I can speak to the dead.
But no doubt their souls live on in one or two of the villagers of Stalwart. Like fine wine poured into a cheap pot.
Derision curls his lips. I'd rather speak to one of the soul essences of the dwarves, actually. It would make sense, as a watcher.
But to identify them, that is the first problem. You would need the skills of an animancer.
He wags a finger at the ceiling. Let's not give that away yet. You're an animancer. The golem's head turns in one slow, oil-smooth movement.
Yeah, Galvino, why don't you go back to Stalwart? Oh, there's a sight I'd rust my joints to see.
Ha, awesome.
Enough!
He snatches an ink pot from the desk and hurls it at the golem. It flies wide, splattering the wall with ink. Motionless, the golem watches him with her black glass eyes.
I shall speak no more of that damned village.
Galvino's mouth and brows have calcified into a stern expression. Well, I'm a watcher. The golem swivels her head sharply toward you, her mask of a face and the glassy eyes behind it betray no emotion, but it seems as if she's watching you carefully.
A watcher? Diverus? If this is true, then you could find a soul descendant from Durgan's battery, no question.
Right.
But the greater difficulty remains.
Galvino rubs his gaunt, whiskered cheeks.
You would have to learn the Cantec from the dormant soul. And to do that, you would have to awaken it.
Awaken someone? How would I do that?
An awakening is merely the jolting of a dormant soul into consciousness.
He makes a bursting motion with his hands, splaying his fingers wide.
When such things happen normally, it is because something has reminded the subject of a past life, often violently so.
He smacks his workbench with surprising vigor. Aeloth flinches.
Thus, to awaken one of the former dwarves of Durgan's battery, you will need to address that soul, preferably by name.
He folds his hands together, steepling his fingers.
But show some care. When you examine these souls, whatever it is you watchers do, you may see images, memories.
He leans forward, his back hunched.
These are moments of special import. What you see will tell you much about the person, and perhaps the condition in which they awaken.
He raises his hoary eyebrows and tilts his head back.
Awaken them from a traumatic memory, and who knows? Maybe they awaken thirsty for blood. Or maybe you awaken someone else.
Aeloth says, you understand the consequences of an awakening as well as any, Theodas. Yet perhaps there's a benefit to the process as well.
Here. This has been tuned to the Aeon of Durgan's battery. Use it near the villagers, and it should tell you if one has a soul old enough to have come from the battery.
He rummages around and produces an unfamiliar device. We've gained a Galvino's resonance amplifier. But this awakening would be permanent, wouldn't it?
Oh, yes. Whoever you awaken will live with the memories and the personality of a past life. Maybe peacefully, maybe not.
His bony shoulders rise in a shrug.
That is why you must pay attention to the soul you would awaken, no? It is a monumental thing to impose on another, but these are the very people who wish to rediscover the White Forge, Verus.
He removes his spectacles and polishes the dirty lenses with his tunic. So the Cantec is all I need?
Who can say? None have yet opened Durgan's battery.
Galvino raises his hands, palms up. He does a lot of things with his hand. He's very gesturific.
But the ones that came before you, I think they got close. You may wish to find them and see what they discovered.
I found what's left of them. A journal and a tile.
Most interesting.
Forget the tile. I don't know. He adjusts his spectacles as he peers at the tile.
They spent many days at the battery door. This looks like something that once belonged there.
He taps the tile. Hold on one second.
Who can say? But the ones that came before you...
Where would they be?
I think I have not seen them since they first came to see me several weeks ago. But word has reached my ears that they crossed an ogre matron.
I see. Thank you for your help. He dismisses the thought with a wave of a hand.
It is a pleasure to have such a courteous guest for a change. A shame you must dirty your boots in Stalwart.
Yeah, it's more snow than anything else.
I'm going with her.
The golem looks between you, her neck turning on its oiled joint.
You? Go to Stalwart? Is this your macabre sense of humor, or has something gone to rust in that beautiful head I crafted?
Galvino stares at her, agape. I have to move things around with Canna, so I'm not going to have her join us just yet. But when I get back to Stalwart, to Stalwart, and then I'll head back to the Stronghold, and then I'll switch to her. Galvino stares at her, agape.
No one will bother me while I'm with her. Besides, I can help her find people in Stalwart.
The golem's burnished face is eerily impassive.
You haven't been to Stalwart in 13 years. And this watcher sees souls. What help could you be? Besides, I have need of you here. You owe whatever remains of your wicked life to me.
A frown sours on his lips as he taps his chest with a crooked finger. The golem says nothing, but her essence smolders. Resentment rises from her in shimmering waves. She swivels her head to look at you. What's the story between you two?
This charming specimen is a convicted murderer. The Devil of Caroc, she's called.
Mighty fine of you to start with my good qualities, and you wonder why we don't get more visitors.
She's awesome looking.
Killed over a dozen people before they finally caught up to her in Stalwart. Perfect company for lonely camps and mountain passes, no?
He nudges you, all the while grinning wickedly at the motionless golem. Yeah, she reminds me of Jocasta from the Avengers comics. Well, I haven't seen the Avengers movie, the Rise of Ultron, I believe it's called, or something of Ultron. But she was in the comics back in the 70s or early 80s. She was originally created to be the bride of Ultron. And she basically has the Wasp's personality inside her. Pretty interesting and kind of a forgotten character for a while.
Hey, I know how to start a campfire.
She didn't have a personality like this, though, but she kind of looks similar. But she had, like, kind of, like, hair coming down like this, but it was actually metal, like curved metal. She was pretty cool looking.
The only reason she's not a frozen corpse is because I convinced the old mayor to let me try an experiment.
A shadow passes over his face. Why is she called the Devil of Caroc?
She committed her first crime in the village of Caroc. Burned a family alive in their home.
He shrugs. Burned a family alive?
Did the same thing in half a dozen other villages, but the name stuck.
Why did you build her?
Why build a fortress, or a village, or anything? To make something that keeps, that...
A disgusted sigh rattles in his throat.
It was the early days of the legacy. My peers in the colleges of animancy were filling the Hollowborn with the souls of animals.
He pauses, scratching his chin. Aloth says, "You're right. By comparison, this sounds perfectly sane." He rolls his eyes.
I thought there was a better way.
He is silent for several seconds, his gaze growing distant.
One with a Plum Academy job back in Salona? Don't forget that part.
He glares at her with narrowed eyes. Pelagius says, "Ach, now we come to the truth. Reputation is everything in the Republics. And that reputation is built on success. Aren't you afraid she'll murder you?"
She may be mad, but she's no fool. She wouldn't survive long on her own.
He shrugs.
If the villagers didn't send a hunting party after her, the Eremans would claim her. Her joints and mechanisms require maintenance, and she cannot perform all of it herself.
See, he's reminding me, in case I get any bright ideas.
So you put a person's soul into a metal body. He leans back, raising his hands.
Into a work of art! Look at this! Craftsmanship worthy of a jeweler!
He traces the scroll work that runs along the golem's jaw.
Fully articulated joints, capable of grasping a pen and writing her own name.
He grabs her hand and delicately bends her tapered fingers.
And of crushing your throat.
She snatches her hand away.
Show me another smith anywhere in the Deerwood who is capable of such delicacy and precision. She is a masterpiece.
Galvino steps back and takes a longer look at her. I take it your experiment didn't go over so well with the rest of the village.
Here we go.
She rolls her eyes, rasping them against her sockets.
They were going to stone her anyway. Why not allow her to be put to some useful purpose?
His lips curl back from yellowing teeth.
My life's ambition. To serve somebody's useful purpose.
I want to find out why she'd burned a family alive. Palagina says better that than no purpose at all.
I approached Mayor Sinahiod and begged. He saw the potential and allowed me the privilege of attempting my little experiment.
He sneers at the words and the indignity they recall. His shoulders are stooped and his teeth bared.
Then, I accomplished what few animancers have even dreamed of. No academic support, no patron. Just me in the middle of nowhere.
He jabs a finger into his concave chest.
Oh, now you got him all wound up.
I transferred a fully intact soul from a living subject to a fabricated body. She retained her personalities, her memories, all of it.
He claws at the air with one thick veined hand.
Yet the villagers saw only a stolen corpse.
He throws up his hands. That's all I wanted to know.
She's a fine specimen, her personality notwithstanding.
He waves one hand in a circular motion. The golem says nothing, but her essence smolders. Resentment rises from her shimmering waves. Yeah. I'm gonna actually... Hold on a second. I'm gonna bring her, but I'm gonna say this for now. I have no need of the golem's company right now. Farewell.
A moment. You are going back to Stalwart, yes? Perhaps you could do me a favor.
Galvino gives you a thoughtful frown. Tell me about this favor.
There is a man in the village named Grinde, the head fisherman.
He weaves his fingers together. Oh yeah, we've met him.
The rest of Stalwart kisses his feet because he fills their stinking blades with speckleback. But I know he's not as virtuous as he seems.
His face crinkles in vicious glee. Hey, I'd kiss his feet. Well, not exactly, but fish are awesome. Seems like you have a history with Grind.
That self-righteous meddler engineered my eviction from the village. He turned them all against me. Now I want him to feel the scorn of those mush-brained imbeciles.
What exactly do you want me to do to him?
Humiliate him, of course. Show his neighbors what he truly is, and let him live with the disgrace.
He points vaguely in the direction of the village, his thin arm trembling.
He's always been a ripper sponge addict. Just got good at hiding it once his sainted sister died and left him in charge of the fishery.
A ripple sponge addict?
But he keeps a stash in the fishery, sneaks in at night when the others have gone home, and emerges sluggish and red-eyed a few hours later.
Huh. Been watching him, huh?
I want you to expose him. Go to the fishery after dark when it's empty. Find his ripple sponge and show it to Renengild.
I see.
Do not answer me now. But when you return to that festering eyesore and smell the stink of fish that hangs in the air, consider what I've said.
He grins.
Besides, you appreciate a good joke, don't you? Diverus, this will be a great one.
Oh yeah, hilarious.
But be sure to approach the fishery by night, when it's empty. They will give you no end of trouble if they see you stealing during the day.
Got it. That's why they have a day-night cycle in the fishery, which seems to be the only place in the game that has it. As far as gameplay mechanics. Not mere graphics. The only other thing I noticed is that during the night, the named NPCs who have the histories, there's not as many of them around. Got more questions. Tell me again how to awaken someone.
You're the Watcher, so you know better than anyone, Diverus. You must find a soul descendant of one of the dwarves of Durgan's battery. Talk to the villagers, look into their souls, whatever it is you do.
He waves a hand.
When you find such a one, remind the sleeping soul of its old name. Awaken it thus, and it can teach you the Cantec. Something else? Quay.
Quay. What were those constructs I encountered in your workshop?
Other projects. They are none of your concern.
He waves a hand and looks quickly away from you. Perception 14-15? You seem pretty eager to change the subject. He mutters furiously under his breath, raising his hands to the ceiling.
For years I've been trying to create another like the Devil of Caroc. Yet those post-Denacos in Stalwart destroyed my machinery.
His drooping skin trembles in his rage. Drooping skin, trembling. Yeah, that's in. That's a very intimidating rage. Full sarcasm intended.
Now, I can only create these broken, mindless things. The devil remains my most perfect creation.
His lips twist with the taste of something bitter. Wait, where have you found the souls to create these other golems?
Smugglers, slavers, fugitives. The kind of riffraff that passed this way. Rarely missed, and good work to keep my little devil busy.
He shrugs. Why do you need more golems?
I can't present the Devil of Caroc to the academies, can I? A mad woman and a murderer? No. I need to bring a success to the Republics.
He rubs his hands together, frowning. Never mind.
Something else? Quay.
I wanted to know more about the expeditioners who came to you before.
As would I, but there is little to tell. They never gave their names.
He tugs at his whiskers.
But they seem to know more about the battery than the others, which is unusual because they did not seem like typical adventurers.
He raises his snowy eyebrows.
Their hands were smooth and marked with ink, not scars, and they traveled light. Unusually so.
He rubs at his chin. Unusual indeed, Aeloth remarks. What do you suppose they were looking for?
Val himself could not have said, and I haven't the time to concern myself with the business of strangers.
I wonder if that's Fiara's band that she's looking for. I had questions about the Devil of Caroc. Caroc?
As must the gods themselves.
He looks to the ceiling and opens his hands. Okay. Discuss another matter.
Something else?
Farewell. According to Galvino, if I'm to enter Durgan's battery, I'll need its Cantac, a poem the dwarves would have used back when the keep was active. Unfortunately, anyone who would have known it is dead. However, Galvino suggested that Stalwart may contain soul descendants of those dwarves. Given my abilities, that won't be hard to find. I could learn the Cantac by awakening one of the souls. That may also doom someone to a fate like mine, or Meyerwald's. Good point. Galvino believes that Grin keeps a stash of ripple sponge somewhere in the fishery. He warned me to search the building at night when all the fishermen have gone home. What? Why would I do this anyway? Just because he wants me to? I mean, I assume he'll give me some kind of cash reward or something. Alright, gonna call an episode here. We can talk to the Devil of Caroc. And we can look around the room, obviously. I'm going to end up sending her to the, Stronghold, and then I'll retrieve her after I'm done exploring this region. Well, thanks for watching. See you next time when I talk more with the Devil of Caroc and explore some more of Galvino's workshop. And we're gonna let this guy go into prison as well. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.